Hello friends and welcome to Lot of Tech once again. So a few days back I have uploaded a video on the JBL T210 and I have also used the JBL T200A and I have made a dedicated video on that as well. So in this video I am mainly going to talk about the difference between the JBL T210 as well as the JBL T200A. After watching my videos on these two earphones, few of you have bought them and were very satisfied, while there were few of you who are not that satisfied with the sound quality. So at the end of the video, I'll also give you few tips that will help you decide in buying the best earphones for yourself. So let's quickly begin with the video, and before moving ahead, don't forget to give a like and subscribe to the channel. So first I'll start with the build quality of JBL T210, and as you can see that these earphones come in this kind of a dual color earbuds in orange and black, and you have a rose gold variant of this also available. Apart from that, the earphones are made completely out of plastic, but it does not feel cheap at all. These earphones come with an inline microphone, and I quite like the button which is onto the microphone because it's very soft and clicky for ending and receiving calls. Apart from that, if you will have a look at the 3.5 mm jack, then it's given at an angle, so it definitely prevents the sharp bending and twisting of wires. Apart from that, if you will pick up and hold the entire headphone in your hand, you will yourself feel that they are very sturdy and durable in terms of quality. So now talking about the JBL T200A, so these earphones are also made completely out of plastic, but the plastic used on the JBL T210 is much better as compared to the plastic used in the JBL T200A. These earphones also come with an inline microphone, but here the entire microphone acts as a button for ending and receiving calls, and I personally like the button which is there on the JBL T210 because it's very soft and clicky. Apart from that, the 3.5 mm jack in the JBL T200A is very straight, so in this situation you have to just keep in mind that your wires do not get twisted at sharp angles, otherwise it may get damaged. I have been using these earphones for around 1.5 years, so you can see that my cable has got cracked at many places. I believe that the plastic used in this one is quite of an inferior quality, because I don't expect these kind of things to happen with a brand like JBL, and I personally believe that the JBL T210 comes with a better plastic as compared to the JBL T200A. The other important thing that you should keep in mind is that the cable provided with the JBL T200A is rounded, so it's always tangled whenever you are taking them out of your pocket. On the other hand, the wires provided with the T210 is flat, and that is the reason they don't get tangled and you don't have the chances of getting the physical damage while taking your earphones out of your pocket or out from your bag. If I talk about the sound quality, the JBL T210 definitely sounds better in terms of loudness and bass as compared to the JBL T200A. It does not mean that the JBL T200A are inferior. Both the earphones produce excellent sound. They have excellent melodies, excellent bass, treble, and both the earphones are very balanced in terms of sound quality. If I talk about the price, then you will get T210 at around 1100 and the JBL T200A come at around 700 to 800. But I definitely want you to go for the T210 because here you are getting a product which is much durable as compared to the JBL T200A. I've already made the dedicated unboxing and review of both the earphones, so you can just go through the link in the description and watch them for more details. So now I would like to give you a few tips that will help you out in buying the best earphones for yourself. So first of all, it's a misconception that the expensive earphones are going to have a good amount of bass. Now this is not always true because earphones are designed for a specific kind of people. There are people who don't like a lot of bass because it gives them a headache, and there are people who like to have a good and voice clarity, good mid-tones. So if you're going to buy a new earphone, do make sure that you read the specifications and also the reviews of the people who are using them. The second important thing here is that if you are going to buy a new earphone, I would recommend you to buy from a retail store like Chroma or Reliance Digital if you are staying in India, because if you are going to buy them from an online store like Amazon or Flipkart, there is a lot of chances that you get a duplicate product, because there is like lot of not that good amount of quality control when it comes to buying earphones. Although it's a possibility that you are going to get the earphone maybe 100 or 150 rupees more expensive on a retail store like Chroma or Reliance Digital, but you will definitely get a genuine product. The third important thing here to note is that with every earphone you get different kind of earbuds of various sizes. Now make sure that you always replace the earbud according to the size that best fits your ear, because it is very important that you get a good noise isolation from isolation from the external sound. Now, if you are already using a earphone from a certain brand, or if you have newly ordered a certain earphone and you don't like the sound, now instead of trying out other model numbers from the same brand, do go for other brands, because if you are not liking particular kind of a sound from a certain company, it's there are chances that you won't be liking any of the other models from the same company. So if you are using a JBL, go for a Skullcandy or a Sennheiser or for any other brand. So friend, this was all about the video, and I hope the video was very helpful. Apart from that, my next video will be on the various kind of skins that you can apply to your mobile phones. So stay tuned to the channel, and thank you so much for watching. A lot of tech.